My name is Amy Jacobson, and I'm a third-year graduate student at UCSF at the Mission Bay campus here, and I study the interaction of the bacteria that live in the human gut with the immune system, and we hope that this may have applications to treatment of inflammatory bowel diseases. My degree's in chemistry, so I'm interested in molecules. And so I do genetics in this one particular bacterium to try to change the structure of this molecule to then change the way that the immune system reacts to that bacterium. Well, when I was little, I really wanted to be a veterinarian. And so people told me, okay, if you want to be a veterinarian, you have to be really good at science. You know, in seventh grade, I think I remember like starting to really pay attention to my science classes. I'd been really good at math before then. And so I was like, okay, well, now I've got to focus on science if I want to be a veterinarian. And then at some point, I think really early on in high school, I actually worked for, I think I lasted about 3 hours in a veterinary clinic before I almost passed out when they like tried to, they had to cut like a mole off of a dog and it wasn't going to work for me. But I really loved the science classes and math classes. And so I kept at it in high school and I took an advanced placement chemistry course, and it was the hardest class that I'd ever taken. And I actually probably did the worst in that class that I did in any of my other classes in high school, but it just sort of made me pay more attention to it. And it just made me fight with the subject and just sort of take notice of the subject material a lot more. And so then when I went to college, I decided I wanted to stick with that subject, even though it was really, really difficult for me. As soon as I got into a lab in college where I was able to actually, you know, not just be doing problem sets and homework and reading textbooks, but actually like getting in and doing the science, that was something that I definitely wanted to keep doing, and that the best way to do that was to come to graduate school and then hopefully be able to continue on afterwards. The very basic question that I'm asking is what's going on in a normal case, so in just a person walking around who is not diseased in any way or doesn't have anything wrong with them, what is their normal interaction with their gut bacteria? More and more, as we learn about these diseases, so inflammatory bowel diseases, which would be like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, these diseases, they don't have cures because we don't really understand why they happen in the first place. And so there's a lot of people doing research on trying to figure out what's going on. And it seems like some part of it is people can have genetic mutations. So you might not be the same as the person standing next to you genetically. And so that may factor into whether you get an inflammatory bowel disease, but also which bacteria are living in your gut seems to also be very influential. And can we control the bacteria that are living in your gut? So potentially could, if you don't have inflammatory bowel disease, but the person next to you does, could we learn something? Could we maybe fix their problem by making their gut bacteria community look more like yours? Generally, every day I come in and I do what we call cloning, or if you wanted to be fancy, molecular biology. But I guess cloning has, most people think of like cloning an organism or making an exact copy. But when we say cloning, it's just manipulating DNA. I work with this bacterium called Bacteroides theta iota omicron, which we call theta because that's a mouthful. So I work with this organism and I'm trying to change the structure of a molecule, but you could do that chemically. You could actually make the molecule with a whole bunch of synthetic tools, and you could do a bunch of synthetic reactions and build this really complicated molecule, but essentially that would take me a lot longer than just trying to get the bacteria to do the chemistry for me and make a bunch of this molecule, and then I can just grow up a whole bunch of the bacteria and then purify the molecule out of it. The other thing that I work on is putting in a protein from a different bacterium that does a different function to the same molecule. So something that the original bacterium was never able to do, I can take a protein from a different organism and I can put it into my bacteria that I work with and make it do that function on my molecule. And that's all done by just transferring DNA from one organism to another. So that's where the bacterial strains that I'm making, the ones that have different versions of this molecule, could come into play. So potentially, we hope that one of the strains that I'm making you could be eventually used to colonize a person with inflammatory bowel disease and just calm down the level of disease that they're seeing and allow your good bacteria to sort of take back over the community instead of the shifted, strange, bad bacteria that are in there. There are all of these tools that we use every day just, you know, without really paying much attention to them, and it must have taken people, you know, decades to figure some of the stuff out that, we're able to take advantage of. And then you're thinking, well, maybe I'm developing something that 50 years from now somebody is just going to be, you know, standard protocol that everybody's going to be using, and that's pretty exciting to think of. So.